Now let us look at the question number 5 here, and this question number 5 is from the C++ programming. Now in this question they are just asking whether you know what is the call by reference, what is the call by value, and how addresses are passing through the various functions. Okay, now mostly many students did the answer wrong. For example, in this slide also, as you can see, this student who sent this paper, he also did the answer wrong. Now what I've done is I've created these three programs here to explain you how this option number A is wrong, how option number B is saying, what option number C is saying, and what option number A is saying, in which cases actually the parameter passing, in which case actually the values will be passed. So they are saying that given below are three implementations of the swap function in C++. So they are giving the three implementations here. Which of these would actually swap the contents of the two integer of the variables which are p and q? So let us take the first function here. I just copied this first function in this program. As you can clearly see here, I've taken this so that I can make you understand the program. I can explain you the program much thoroughly here. So the execution will start from the main function. In the main function, we have two variables. One is the variable p, and second one is the variable q. Variable p is storing 0 and variable q is storing 1. Now we have the swap p and q. From this swap function, we are copying this value from here to here, and we are copying the value of q from here to here. So this is called as copying. Okay. Now again in the swap function here, this variable a, which is storing the value of p, which is 0, and this variable b, which is storing the value of q, which is 1. Now we have a variable integer temp. So this temp variable is there. Then we are making temp is equal to a. So a is storing the value 0. So temp will be storing a. A is equal to b. So a will be storing the value which is stored by b, which is 1. And b is equal to temp. So b will be storing the value of the temporary variable, which is 0. So a will be storing 1, b will be storing 0. As soon as this function finishes, the control will go back to the main function, but these values are not copied back. They are not copied back. So this is called as the call by value. Call by value. For the first case, these values will not be interchanged. So the value of p will be 0 and the value of q will be 0. So the value will not change. They will not change. Okay. So here you can clearly see the first case here. Here we can say the values will not change. Will not change. Okay. Now let us take the second case, which is option number B, and this option number B is also a classical example of call by reference. Now for this case again, the program execution will start from the main function. We have a variable p which is storing 0, and we have a variable q which is storing 1. We are swap p and q, and as you can see here, we are creating ampersand a and ampersand b. So this is call by reference, but it is similar to aliasing. Similar to aliasing. That means this variable a is actually pointing to this location only, or it is the same location. If you print the address of a, if you print the address of b, you'll find the address will be same as the address of p and q, and this variable b will be pointing to this location. Now we have a temporary variable temp, and this temporary variable is there, and then when I'm doing temp is equal to a, now this temporary variable will be storing the value which is stored by a, which is 0. And a is equal to b, at the index location a we are storing 1, and b is equal to temp, that means in index, in this b we are storing 0. Okay, so these values are actually interchanged. Now if you print the value of p and q, now these values will be interchanged, will be interchanged, because this is the example of call by reference. Call by reference. So in the second case here, these value will interchange, and it is call by reference. Okay, now let us see the option number C. Now in case of option number C, as you can see here, we have the variables. This is an interesting case. We have a variable p which is storing 0, the variable q which is storing 1, assuming the address of p is 1000 and the address of q is 2000. Now here in the swap function, because it is called by reference, so we are passing the addresses of p and q. So we have a variable a which is storing 1000, we have a variable b which is storing 2000. Now we are taking a temporary variable temp, okay, which is also a pointer. When I'm doing temp is equal to A, so temporary variable will be storing the address stored by A, which is 1000. Now A is equal to B, so A will be storing the address 2000, and B is equal to temp, so B will be storing the address which is stored by temp, which is 1000. So as you can clearly see, we are just changing their addresses. We are just making changes here. We are just changing the addresses. We're just changing the content of A and B. Content of A and B. We are not changing the content of P and Q. So the content of P and Q will not be changed. Only the content of A and B, they will be changed. Okay. So in this case, you can clearly see this content will not change. This content of P and Q will not change. Will not change. Okay. And this here, you can see here, why they will not change, because here instead of this, if you could have written something like this, temp is equal to, instead of taking star temp, I could have taken, okay, so star temp, I could have taken temp is equal to star of A is equal to star of B, and star of B is equal to temp. If this code could have been like this, then only their content will change. Now, because here we are not changing the actual content of the main memory location, I mean, to the real memory location, we are just changing the contents of these pointers. Okay, so this content will not change. So if you see the option number A, option number 1 is wrong, option number 2 is correct, option number 3 is wrong, and option number 4 is also wrong. So the correct answer to this question is option number 2, and it's a very nice question. You just have to understand what is the call by value and what is call by reference. And this question is similar to the previous year gate questions. As you can go back to the previous year, if you check the previous year gate questions, it is actually similar to that, only it came into one mark question in gate. Okay, now let us look at the question number 6.